1 year ago, we dreamed the animal IAF could be a thing.
Eye detection for an animal would be insane.
Every wildlife photographer would have to switch over.
Can you make this camera for me?
This is how I do it, I tell the manufacturers.
Today, Sony released a firmware update that included animal IAF. Our dream is becoming a reality. So far, it only works on mammals like dogs and cats, but it also seems to work on lions, bears, things like that. But hopefully soon it will also work for birds, because that's what I'm into. I'm gonna toss this over to Tony so he can cover all the nerdy stuff.
I tested both the a7III and the a7R3, and they both seem functionally identical. The eye autofocus for humans is definitely improved. Watch our A9 firmware update video to see those changes, because it's pretty similar to the A9. It's definitely much better. Animal IF is a different story. Like, technically it works, and I can show you lots of examples that would make it look perfect, but it's not my job to make it look good. It's my job to tell you whether or not it's useful to you so that you can decide whether this might be a camera you want to buy. Right now, nobody should buy one of these cameras specifically for animal IAF. It is simply too inconsistent. It finds the eye in some situations, but not in others. It seems to depend on the lighting that the animal is in and the colors of the animal. Sony says that it's for cats and dogs, but I found that it worked for a wide variety of mammals, everything from groundhogs to lions to bears, just looking at static images. But in all those images, the eyes were illuminated pretty brightly. If you do decide to use it after updating the firmware, I suggest that you assign it to the FN menu, because the only other way to turn it on is to go into the menu system, and it's kind of buried on a deep page. Just like human IAF, you can assign it to automatically work with the shutter button or to work with a separate button. I would not recommend assigning it to work with the shutter button automatically, because if you do that, well, it's getting a lot of false alarms for me, especially with my black and white dog. It'll just grab onto black and white spots other places on the dog and focus on that. And then if it's automatic and always turned on with a shutter button, then you're not going to be able to turn that off. It's going to make you miss shots. Here's the biggest problem with animal IAF, and the reason I can't recommend it right now. It finds the eye and selects the nearest autofocus point, but then it doesn't hunt for the eye. It simply focuses on the first thing that it finds. And for me, in about 90% of cases with my two dogs, it latched on to eyebrow fur or the nose or something in proximity, because animal faces are shaped differently from human faces. Human faces are much easier. So for the time being, it's fun to play with and it has a lot of potential, but I would suggest just using that thumbstick and manually selecting the animal's eye. If you're having a hard time getting it to work, get close to the animal, lock on with the animal IAF, and then step back. If it can find the eye up close, it'll keep tracking it as you move back, but it often won't find it from a greater distance. Besides improved human IAF and animal IAF, they added an intervalometer to the a7R III and a7 Mark III. Finally, thank you. We've been asking for that for so long, and I'm really glad to not have to carry a separate intervalometer anymore when I want to make time lapses. But Sony, can I make one big request? Improve your menu system. Interval shoot funk? Who would guess that that means time lapses? And right above that, the menu item is reg cust shoot set. Is this Dothraki? What are you doing? I will make you an offer that will not require you to write a single line of code. Send me the dictionary file for this, and I will make a new language called English Simplified. I will translate all of these complex menu settings into simple human English terms. And then in the next firmware update, you can distribute that as an option. It will not change anybody's menu settings by default, but those who opt for English Simplified will have menu items that are a lot more readable. By the way, this firmware update did not erase my custom settings, so you listened to us just from the A9 firmware update like a month ago. Thanks so much, Sony, for improving the human IAF. It's exciting to see the animal IAF, even though I can't recommend it right now. I know in a couple of years, we're gonna be using it all the time for animals and hopefully bird photography too. If you wanna actually learn photography, check out Stunning Digital Photography, the number one photography book in the world. Subscribe for free photography tutorials. Check us out live every Thursday at 5 o'clock, where we will review your photos. Give us a like, and if you wanna let me know how this firmware update is working for you, or if you have questions about it, write a comment down below. Bye.